All right, so I figured out how to record with MSI Afterburner, my desktop, that is. And I finally have a little time here after exam. So here we are in the documents folder, have all my Blender files. Go ahead and open this up. And so this is my current little project I'm working on. I have it set up for the working with of the Krauss I made. So this was gonna be a Unverth or whatever the hell it was, Unverfirth. Unverfirth. Anyways, I can't even say it. But now it's gonna be a Great Plains just because I had better pictures. So I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and work on the hitch area right here, just so you guys can see how I do that. So I had the model and I kind of just tweaked it a little bit from the old one. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna take this. This. This is from the old. You can zoom in I'm just gonna move this out here. I'm gonna select this, delete all this, do this, get rid of that. Alright, so what does our hitch look like? It kind of has two things that come down square. Okay, not bad. So let's just go to quick create a cube. Bring it on over here. So this is just eyeballed, nothing special. Come here, do a quick shrink. And then where do we go from here? We go kind of has an angle, comes down. So we'll just extrude this, move it down a little bit. And then we will. Don't know why my camera's so off, but. And then we'll just take these until they kind of look normal. Take this, put on my vertex just so they're the same. Use my face select tool. Take this, stretch it out a little bit. Alright, so that's basically that a little bit. Then what we want is we want our hitch unit to be like this. So I'll just shrink this down, stretch it out, shrink it down. It's a little bit bulky. Move it back to like there. One out there. So duplicate. Okay, so what do you have left to do? We have to. So what I plan on doing is using my bullet in tool and see how it has kind of like a little weird thing going on here. So what I'll do is I will extrude this out just to get my little extra, and then. And then I'll probably put in a loop cut here, move it in, get a little bit more round. Put a loop cut in here, make it a little more round. Another loop cut in here, get accentuate the curves a little bit. Pretty good. And then what I want to do is I want to take this, duplicate it, kind of shrink it down a little bit. How are they? Okay, so it's just a little bit. So I will extrude this up. I will sink it in about like that. Actually make it a little bit bigger. Then I will use this tool. Get rid of these guys. Move this into about there. Select that one and that one and that one and that one. And then move it in. So we get a nice offset right there. And then what I'll do is I will take my face tool again, just so we get those the curves that we really want. Do something like that. I actually think that's a little. First, I'll move it back. Move this back. Could do another loop cut. And the angulation's a little bit. Alright. So you can see that I overextended this. So I'm gonna do a quick select, separate by object. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this tool, I'm gonna go to modifiers, use this, disappears, go to difference, see how that appears, apply. Alright. And then get rid of this because this is just garbage. So this is what we have left. Let's go ahead there. Merge at center. Merge at center. Control all. Remove doubles. Merge those. Anytime you use that modifier, it's kind of annoying. So we want to round these off, see if we can do a bevel. Nope, not like a stupid. So we'll see if we can do something like that. Do something like that. Select this edge, select that edge, deselect that. Move it up. Now, we'll use our face tool and actually do it ourselves. So sometimes the geometry you're using won't allow you to use modifiers and so on. So like this, I kind of want to increase my angulation here, like make it a little sloped. So I'll just progressively increase the slopage And there we go. It's looking pretty decent now. Then what we want to do is we want to create a cylinder. A big cylinder. Modifier again. Difference. Apply. Get rid of it. Doubles. Alright. Not bad, not bad. And then, another little actually. Just kidding. Screwed up somewhere, but I think what I want to do. Why are these? See, this is why a lot of people don't like Blender, is because the modifiers, they're not that intelligent, I guess you can say. Because if you have unconnected vertices and you're trying to use like bevels and such, it makes it pretty difficult. For whatever reason, these down here are fine. I think what I'll do is I'll move this up a little bit. Like that. That's fine. I'm trying to think. If I were to do this. Here, something extracted out. And I can. Cancel that idea. I'm not liking how that's turning out. Do something like this instead. Just kidding. It's a much better idea. Alright, so that's a hitch. Let me just take this. Duplicate it over. And then if you really want to get fancy with it, you can do crazy stuff like add an extra geometry. Stretch it out a little bit more. Maybe make this a tad bit. Works for me. And then I have this stuff over here. Actually, take the stuff I already made. Zap it on over. So we'll put that like right there or something. And that was actually I made these too big, so. Select them, but only do one at a time. So I'll put it down to there. Zap that. Do the same thing here. And then that. It's a little bit more reasonable. So, as you can see, you can kind of get carried away with really irrelevant details, but that's what makes it fun. So, at the end of the day, I didn't even have to actually put a hole in there. I'm so used to putting the hitches on the implement. This implement will actually be towed behind another trailer. So I actually didn't need to do that. So we will go back and look at what else needs to be done. Alright, so this area, little triangle things. So now, down here, these can actually be squished a little bit more. Brought down to like right there. That and that. Oops. As you can see, it's been a long day. Look at this. Let's take this entire thing. Okay. So that's pretty much done. Always a good idea to save. So my idea is to have this shaft. It's it It's a sleeve. I just have it all the way extruded out for burning purposes. So the whole thing will be nice and green. Went ahead and made these, and then I'm just working on. I had a different frame because it was a different model. It's the model. It was a 1225 initially, so I just went ahead and duplicated and used a mirror modifier. All there is to that. So I kept some of the frame I made. I kept and you see how it kind of just so we'll go ahead and do like another loop. We'll do another loop cut, drag it out to like here, drag it somewhere there, and then we'll just zap this up there. So it's starting to look like something at this point. Once we start working on the frame, we'll go pretty quickly. Alright, so I will show you guys a little trick on how to do U-bolts. First, let me see if we can get alright, well, we'll do we'll just rough frame in quick and then go from there. So this just do a quick rough in. What I usually like to do is like model one half and then deselect it and then use mirror modifier so it's perfectly symmetrical. So usually I do that once I like build one side. I'll like get a rough layout and then I'll just go and just do one side and one side only. And delete the other like odds and ends, but I just do it for like scaling proportion purposes, and seems to typically work well. So I'll just take like a nice little square piece here. Get it out. So I don't have to make another cube. And you can see that we want to let's go ahead and rotate that. 90. Stretch it out. Like that. Let's see how we're doing. Right up here. A little bit. Right up here. So this is where our hinge. See how they have it set up? It's basically just a square thing. Maybe it has like a one of these things going on, so we'll just do that. This. Actually, I want this to be a little bit further out. Then we can take some that we've already made, reuse it over here. And ready. It's a little bit about there, seems pretty good. So this video isn't, I'm not slowing down, it's just me building so you guys can see like what I do, how fast I work things, what I do. It's not really a tutorial, it's more for you to just quietly observe. You can pause the video and you know, do what you have to do, but I'm just showing you guys how I go about building some of these things. Pretty much just do it right off from pictures I find, and I actually want to make this just a bit smaller. Maybe we can kind of see how this looks for sizing. So we want our main frame to be a little bit beefier than our outer frame. And we want to move that a little bit. And like this side, I'm not even worried about that side. I'm not gonna do anything with the frame. I'm just gonna do this frame and then replicate it over. So then we have two plates, U-bolt and screws, and then like a cross member piece. So what we'll do is we'll just take this little guy, jack it up here, and so we're going to want to make it just a little bit, flatter, and then we will come and do our 90 degree rotation, shrink it down, shorten it, and see where it lines on the, so it's pretty much right on the outside, which is good, that's someone knows their geometry. You want the greatest stability with the widest base, otherwise it's really not functional. And then we'll take our handy dandy square and we will shrink it, stretch it, There's a little bit more. Too much. There. Straight up. And then. We'll actually have to pull that out a little bit more. What we shall do. Just take this little guy again. Been using this guy all day. Make it a 90. Bring it over here. Just really shrink it down. That seems good. We want our bolt to be underneath. So this is how you guys make really quick. This is how I do my hoses now. I used to use loop bend, like if I'm doing a lot, but I'll do this and then I'll do it like move it over, rotate this entire face 90. So like right about there. Bring it over up. Rotate it 90 degrees again, and to make sure it's perfectly symmetrical, I'll put on my snap to vertices, and then I'll snap to my vertices again. So, it's a little bit too long. Select that unit, deselect it, pull the whole thing back. Then put a loop cut in there, switch to normal, pull it out, stretch it out a little bit. Pull it out, stretch it out a little bit. And that is how you make a U-bolt. And then a square, we'll just go ahead and reuse this. Is it kind of square? It's a little bit more square. We will assign our material, which has a metal texture to it. Extrude it up. Switch back to global. Do our little down, scale it up, and that's how you do that. As you can see, we got our U-bolts in there now. Frames coming together, got some hinges. What else? So, looks like there's actually like a middle. There's a main frame, and then there's a front. So something like that, because that gets deleted.
this gets shortened up and kind of brought into this one. After I do something like that. Kind of side another little U-bolt just back here. So that's a future hinge. So that's about right. You can always test your rotations. By selecting it and setting your origin to 3D cursor and see how looks and where your support should really, really go. And I imagine there's probably like two of these. So we'll just put two. For good measure. And also this should really come in.
have to figure out. I forgot what my rotation is. Okay, so we're knocking this out. We have our rollers, we have our frame, hinge mounts, not the best, but you know, whatever, it works. Maybe make them a little bit thinner, just so they're not so bulky. So this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 components. Maybe I can figure out how to make it multiple. So these things, but this will be mouse controlled, so you can move it in and out. And so, tell you guys how to make nice U-bolts. You've seen me kind of like move all over the place. Let's see here. We need another set. Oh, this is interesting. Okay. So this actually needs to go here. This needs to probably come out to there. And then what we can do is something like this. We could paste, wrote this guy at like 45, move it up, move it over. Obviously it's more than 45. So this would be a prime example to show you what I mean. I selected it. The center of origin is right in the middle. And then I will just use a... where is it? Modifier. Join. And then I'll show you guys again what I mean by... I'll just go ahead and delete these. Pretty satisfied with this. If I wasn't satisfied, I'd go back and fix a few things, but mirror. See how it lines up. That means we will have to move that over a bit. And we have a great majority of this model done. That's all the easy parts. So this is where the landing gear goes. hydraulic mounts. This is interesting. So, I'm getting kind of hungry here, so I'll probably quit the video here, but next time we'll probably work on the wheels here, we'll work on the hydraulics, cylinder mounts, and the cylinders, and I will show you how to do that. Then we'll do our mounts for our roller baskets, and then that's pretty much it for the model. You could put in the little details like the lighting. Those look like they're just bolted on the frame we built. Then we can put in hoses and stuff like that. What is this? This must be like a lock once it's up. Probably like a road lock. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed a Blender tutorial. I'll probably start making more that I know how to record. I'll probably start making more videos on like basic, like when you're first starting, how to do stuff like what a node index is and how to like what that means in the XML and whatnot. So this is going to be a large 50-foot what is it called? I think it's a seedbed prep conditioner or seedbed or soil conditioner or something like that. It's just a heavy roller basket thing you pull behind. So, thanks for watching.